the national strategy is timely to steer ongoing health program, including health development fund, and build on the gain achieved over the last 5 years. For example, the program support facilitated by UNFPA, UNICEF, WHO on reproductive, maternal, neonatal, child, and adolescent health has contributed to the reduction of maternal mortality by 50% in the last 5 years. This is a great achievement led by the Ministry of Health. Government, with support from the Global Fund, USAID, PEPFAR, UNDP, and others, currently provide free HIV treatment to nearly 1 million Zimbabweans, resulting in a steady reduction of the prevalence rate from over 29% to around 13.6 or 7. WFP and UNICEF have been supporting effort in nutrition, water, hygiene, and sanitation, combating malnutrition and waterborne diseases, respectively. These results were made possible by the generosity and a strong partnership of the various development partners, including Australia, Canada, European Union, Ireland, Japan, Sweden, UK, Global Fund, USAID, and others. Ladies and gentlemen, as a result of concerted efforts under the cardinal principle of the national ownership and the leadership of the Ministry of Health, we have noted child and maternal mortality and other health burden indicators have been in decline in the last few years. Notwithstanding the achievement of health challenges, including in the area of reproductive and sexual health, child and maternal health, HIV, TB, waterborne diseases, as well as emerging non-communicable diseases remain huge and is still a challenge. As such, our resolve to strengthen national health system that ensures effective quality and equitable prevention, comprehensive disease surveillance and mitigation must continue unabated. Today, as we commit through this new national health strategy to build on the positive gain made so far, allow me to highlight a few perspectives. First, addressing access to safe and adequate water as well as sanitation and hygiene services for those who lack them would do much to reduce health burden, particularly water-related disease. We have noted the recent and ongoing concern related to typhoid and various efforts by the town council, the Ministry of Health, and local government in terms of addressing those issues. Studies have consistently shown that improvement in water and sanitation coverage, including the implementation of low-cost, simple technology system, can reduce the incidence of diarrhea, cholera, typhoid, and other water-related diseases, which are rearing their ugly head in some part of Zimbabwe. Furthermore, providing water and sanitation confers multiple benefits beyond reducing water-related diseases, including alleviating the time and economic burden of having to collect water, contributing to human dignity, particularly women. Second, we should pay special attention to looming health burden as a result of traffic accident, obesity, tobacco use, gender-based violence, counterfeit medication, and effects of climate change. We must and can easily tackle these with intelligent use of legislation, public education, regulation, and enforcement. Therefore, the role from everyone is extremely crucial. I'm really glad to see Honorable MPs present here to have a very important role to play to address those. Third, revisit the human resources establishment for healthcare. The current establishment in use were from 1980, I understand. As you know, the population has expanded and health problems have also increased. Human capital is directly useful in a reproductive, in a production process. Human capital increases a worker's productivity in all tasks, hence investing in health is synonymous to creating a wealth for nation. Fourth, improving quality and coverage of health service must be addressed across all health program and intervention. To this end, it's absolutely critical that the quality improvement policy
and other stories, visit our website www.263chat.com. Follow us on Twitter @263chat and like our Facebook page 263chat.